Hello everyone, my name is Steven Farrig, owner of Campus Sportswear Screen Printing and Embroidery. We are a medium-sized screen printing company located at the heart of the University of Illinois in Champaign, Illinois. Our shop prints a variety of orders, including screen printing and embroidery. We take orders as small as 12 pieces, but as large as 20,000 pieces. We have several employees that work with us, and whether they are our screen printers, embroiderers, graphic designers, owners, or even our salespeople, everyone at Campus Sportswear relies on Printavo on a daily basis. We've been using Printavo for over a year now and hope this hands-on experience diving into our business will give you a better idea of how you can use Printavo in your business. After setting your shop up in Printavo, which can be done in minutes using the tutorials provided or the Printavo concierge service, you're going to get used to seeing this home screen, which is your calendar. At Campus Sportswear, we have this calendar up on every single device around the shop, including tablets and touchscreen computers. It's also on the cloud, which means nothing is downloaded to your computer, and it gives you the ability to make changes and use it from anywhere at any time. Now, the calendar feature shows all the jobs that are running in our workflow, whether it's the week, the day, or the month. Now, you can see all these orders that have been turned to black, which means they're completed, but if we go to the week that we're on right now, you're going to see a lot of colors. And as you know, this industry has multiple stages, and one of the best features of Printavo is a customized workflow. At our shop, we have several different statuses of orders. Now, the calendar is very flexible, and it allows you to drag and drop orders in order to move them to a different day. Now, if we take a look at our statuses right here, you're able to name these statuses and add as many or as little as you want. In our business, we have not only screen printing, but we also have embroidery. Now, after our customers start as a quote, they can either go to our embroidery department, which is pink, or they can go into our screen printing department. Now, after a quote is approved, we send it over to our art department to start working on our art. And our artists work in this blue department, and anything that's blue is tagged with their name on it. And they're able to work in there, upload their artwork, change the status, and send it to our production department. Now for us, the customizable actions are very important to us because some of our artists work remotely. And now if our artist is working on a job and they notice that there isn't good vector artwork or they're missing a font or there's something inhibiting them from producing the artwork necessary to produce the job, they can go ahead and click on the button that says need more art. And that'll give the invoice creator an automated message that says, hey, we're going to need more artwork from the customer, or we're going to need more artwork from you. So if you could go ahead and send that to us and change the status back to blue, we can go ahead and take care of that for you. Now, we use status change notifications very heavily at Campus Sportswear, whether we're communicating with our customers or our employees in the shop. It's very important that all the people involved in a job know exactly what's going on with it every single step of the way to make sure that everything happens on time and the job is produced perfectly. One other feature that we use heavily with our status change is when a job is completed. Someone in our production line will change the status to completed screen print, which will automatically send an email to our customer telling them that their order has been completed, that there's an attached invoice, and that they can go ahead and come pick up their job in our shop, or they can figure out if they would like us to ship it. We can go ahead and take care of that for them. One part about the status change notification that I really love is that you can pretty much customize it to do anything. So if you'd like, when changing a status, it could do nothing, just so you know in the shop what's going on with the job. Or it can send the invoice creator an email, or it can send the customer an email, or it can send a specific person an email. So for instance, when we use it in our art department, it sends it to our artist's email every single time when there is an issue, and that way they know they're the point person on that status change. Once again, completely customizable. Every single shop is different. Therefore, you're going to need the statuses to be catered directly to how your business works, whether it's that you have direct-to-garment, you have different automatic machines, manual machines, you have embroidery going on, maybe you have sublimated orders, or you're doing ad specialty products. You're going to be able to tag every part of your business with a different color and a different status so that it can create a simple workflow for everyone to use in the shop. Now, after you've gotten comfortable with how the calendar works and how things can move around and how flexible it is, I'm going to dive in a little bit deeper about how you can add a customer, create a quote, and kind of how the invoicing and the system works there. So really simple to add a customer. You can just go into the top here, click add a customer, and you can go ahead and enter in anything you really want about the business. You can enter in their company name, their information. You can even add in additional contacts. Say there's a billing department, or say there's multiple people in a department that are going to be ordering shirts from you. You can put them under one simple address. You can add shipping information if a company is going to be ordering items that are going to be shipped specifically somewhere else. And you can also check if it's going to be tax exempt. Once you check that it's tax exempt, it'll remove tax every time that customer orders, and you can put in the resale number. So after you have created the customer, you can go ahead and either create a quote or you can create an invoice. Now when you're creating a quote for a customer, say I already have in here Stephen Farag, that's me, I can go in here and I can put all the different features I want about the job. So I can give it a nickname and I can call it Stephen's Birthday Shirts. And I can put notes in for the job. Now, in the notes section, that's going to be public, and your customers are going to be able to see the notes. In the production notes, that's going to be just visible to you. So if I want to tell my production guys that this is going to be a left chest, two color with a flash, national red and blue ink, that could be right there. I can also put in the notes up here publicly if I wanted to tell my customers that it's a two-color left chest and it's going to be used red and royal ink, and the customers will be able to see that as well. So in our production notes, we'll put in anything relevant that we think is going to be important for our production team to see. Now, after you put in the notes up top, you can add whatever items you'd like to your invoice. Now, you can add as many different categories as you'd like. We add, you know, things for embroidery, if we're going to be doing banners, if we're going to do custom names or numbers, but for most of the time, we're just using normal adult apparel. Now, Printavo has different catalogs already imported from SNS Activewear, Sanmar, and Alphabroder. So those can be, those are automatically in there, and you can search for products. So say I'm looking for the Gildan 5000, I can go ahead and say I want this in black. It's going to put in all the information in there, and then I can put in the sizes that I'd like. Once I put those in, I can do a couple different things. I can attach a mockup, and when you attach a mockup, you can go ahead and drag and drop files straight from your computer that are going to be used in the order. You can pull them from a camera, you can pull them from Facebook, you can pretty much pull them from just about anything, and once they're uploaded there, they're there on the cloud, not on anyone's computer, and they can be downloaded at any time. So one feature we really like is that we'll upload everything the customer gives us, whether they're JPEGs, PNGs, EPS files, we'll upload everything so that our artists can download it later wherever they're working from. One other thing you can do is you can add specific print locations. Now I will add a two color left chest and I will say it is royal and red, and I will put in there that we need to flash this job because it's going to be done on black. Now Printavo also does have a pricing matrix that you can use. In our business, we really delineate between two major prices, and that's whether we're printing on a dark product or a light product. And so I have two different pricing matrices inserted there. If I'd like to do that, I can go ahead and click on Save and Insert Pricing, and it will automate the prices that I've loaded in for that product. You can find a little bit more about the pricing tutorial if you look through Printavo's tutorial specifically on pricing. But once the locations have been in, the ink colors have been added, it's going to give your employees an opportunity to see exactly what's going on with the job. So after you've attached your mockups, you can actually go ahead and you can mark the status of the product. You could say that it needs to be ordered, the products have been ordered, or the products are in-house. Also here you can duplicate your items if you'd like to create another one. say you're using two XLs and they're going to be a little bit more expensive, you can go ahead and add those in there. And you can, you know, add, say these are $7 and these are $6 right there. Now up here you can add additional fees. If you have a tape fee or a setup fee, you can either add or subtract money. You can also put a discount in. If you have a favorite customer you'd like to reduce money from. You can also go in here and you can add a custom PO number. A lot of different companies that we work with give us PO numbers that they'd like on their invoice, so you can go ahead and place that in there. You can also give it a production due date and a customer due date. We will put our production date a couple days before the customer due date, and we'll put the customer due date just so we know exactly when the customer will be picking that product up. So right here in the invoicing section, everything is everything you change here will reflect it in the invoice after you do it, and you can go ahead and you can change the status of that after, you know, quote, say it's ready to be proofed, so we're going to go ahead and proof. Or we can interact with our customer and we can go ahead and email our customer a quote. Now there's a bunch of different templates that you can customize that tells the customer exactly what's going on. We tell our customers, here's your quote, please approve it, and we'll have a 7 to 10 day turnaround once your quote is approved. Now I can sign that, I can add anything to that, and I can say, hi Steven, and that'll go directly to the customer. One thing about this is it's going to give your customers a page that looks just like this. It's going to have their quote on there. It's going to give them the opportunity to go ahead and approve it. When you approve it, it'll send an email back to the shop, tell the shop that this job has been approved, it's ready to rock and roll. Once that job is done, I can go ahead and click request payment. When I request the payment, I can say, hi Steven, here is your invoice, and what it's going to allow the customer to do is actually go ahead and plug in their credit card information and pay for that job right there. Now your credit card portal can connect right to your merchant account. You can use Stripe, you can use authorize.net, there's a couple different ones in there. I believe we use Stripe. More on the invoice right here, there's a couple different things you can do with the invoice. You can duplicate the invoice, you can download it, you can print it, you can even create a shipping label for it. Once your form manager has ordered the items, they can go ahead and click on, if I click all items need to be ordered, they can actually go in there, click on edit, and they can mark that the products have been ordered. So some features here, you might not use them all to start. The more and more we grow into Printavo, the more and more we use all of these every day. A couple other features that you can do here is you can add expenses for the job. If you'd like to create an expense and say, I spent $46 on shirts for this order, you can put in your PO from that, and you can add that as a transaction, so you can track that. Another thing you can do is you can add tasks to the job, and as you add tasks, they're going to be able to be there for your employees to go ahead and click so that you can assign them to them. They can print out the work order, order apparel checked in. These are all tasks that are customizable, very specific to our shop. One other feature that we have is the ability to chat with customers right away directly from Printavo. So I can tell them, if this is myself, I can tell them your job is going to finish a day early, finish 2 days early, and you can say surprise, and hopefully it's a good surprise that you're sending them. But once you send them in there, when they send a message back, it's going to go right into this chat box. So the invoice section really gives you an opportunity to see exactly what's going on specifically with your jobs. Once again, you can click on any job from any single place. You can see exactly what's going on with that job. You can see all the different thumbnails, all the different proofs that you have for all the products, and it prints out in a very friendly work order. A couple of my favorite features on the invoice section that I use to hold everyone in our shop accountable is the history of a job. Every time something happens in Printavo, it actually keeps a log of it, so you can see exactly what is going on in the job. So I know that one of our employees, Emma, put in this job September 15th, she changed it from a quote, sent it to our art department. Our artist's name is Jed, and she actually changed the production due date from the 16th to the 21st, and changed the due date from the 16th to the 21st. Jed had an issue with his artwork, something was wrong in there, so he said that Jed needs more art. Then we changed it back to redo artwork once Emma re-uploaded the artwork, and then Jed was able to resend an email, which we can see that we needed to send one of our customers' email, and once he approved it, Jed was able to deliver our film, and that we were able to get the job ready to prove. This is really important when you have multiple users using Printavo. You want to know everything that's going on about a single job in case something were to go wrong. It just gives a really detailed log. Another feature that I really like is when you go ahead and add a payment. You can add a payment, and if you have cash, check, bank card, credit card, or a different means of collecting money, you can go ahead and put this in. So if we get a check, we go ahead and put check, and we actually put the check number right here so that we have a running log of it. Really important to us because this takes care of all of our accounts receivable, and when we go to our invoices, we can actually show which ones have been unpaid, and we can go ahead and follow up with them. Another key feature that we use in Printavo is the inquiry form. Really great part about Printavo is it gives you actually a piece of embedded code that you're able to go into your website, and you can actually put it right into the website, and it gives you the ability to allow customers to enter in exactly what they need. For us, I just have this quick quote button, and this short little thing comes up that says, what's your name, your email, your phone number, and what exactly do you need? Once someone fills that out, that comes into our inquiry, and so one of our customers can come in. They can say, oh, I was curious about pricing of an order. I have long sleeve pockets with a print on the back and above the pocket. We have the customer's information, their email address, and we can either give them a call, we can email them, and we can even make them a customer in our system so we can go ahead and process their order. One other feature that we use is the analytics. There are real-time analytics that will show you exactly what's happening in your business. So you can show how much an individual has sold. In our business, we have different employees that sell and work as us, kind of like contract printer or contract salespeople. And so if I want to see exactly how much one of my employees sold, I can go ahead and I can click their name. I can give a date range. I can show exactly how much they've sold in a given amount of time. This will also show you your expenses if you've been entering your expenses. It can actually generate your sales tax. But one feature that you can do at any given point is actually export all of your invoices, all of your payments, all of your customers, and it'll give that to you in an Excel format. Printavo also syncs up with QuickBooks, and it also syncs up with a shipping portal called EasyPost, so it can do your shipping labels. You can learn a little bit about the purchase orders. There's a video that goes through purchase orders. We don't use it specifically yet at Campus Sportswear, though we're going to be starting to use it, where this will automatically send our vendors an email with exactly what has been purchased. So Printavo is very streamlined, very, very simple to use, and extremely customizable. Now, you might be thinking, how in the world am I going to be able to do all of this? And one of the best features about Printavo is probably the customer service. Printavo has a great portal that allows you to kind of search for different things. It's got great video tutorials, and if you're really struggling, you can go ahead and click on the support button, and either Bruce or someone else from Printavo is going to be able to get back to you right away in order to get your problem solved. Printavo is quickly growing with a couple thousand shops using it. We're constantly adding features to it, and Campus Sportswear is very excited to see what the future of Printavo holds. We are extremely enthused customers. We're very proud of our product. Our customers use it on a very daily basis. Our employees use it, and we pretty much live by it. So hopefully this kind of info session gave you an idea of how Printavo works in a real-life business. If you guys have any more questions, feel free to reach out to us if you want to see anything more in detail. I know I went through a lot of things very quickly, but this is how we use Printavo on a day-to-day basis, and hopefully it was helpful to you. Thanks so much.